if you're borrowing a book, please register it in the log. The restricted section is currently not lending any books. Oh, it's you, little cutie. It's so good to see you. More refreshing than a strong cup of tea in the afternoon.
Clearly you're meant to be working, but you don't seem to have your heart in it at all.
I mean, other than Jean, who really works that earnestly anyway? So, did you have something you needed? Or did you just come to see me? Ooh, a smooth talker. Not what I was expecting.
So, Miss Librarian, got any books to recommend?
Recommended books. Sadly, everything I'd personally recommend is all in the restricted section, which we're not currently lending out.
What's with your ominous tone?
Oh, right. Would you be interested in checking out the Devat Travel Guide? I think it would be quite helpful for you as travelers here.
Ooh, sounds like it could be helpful. Do you think we could take a peek?
I suppose I can try to find you a copy.
Isn't this Lisa's job? What?
Oh dear. That's unfortunate. Our copy is currently being borrowed. That said, it is now overdue. Come to think of it, quite a few of our books are now overdue. I really wish people would just return their books on time.
Whoa, is Paimon imagining things, or does the air in here suddenly feel a lot more electrified?
Such a pain. I'm going out to bring those unreturned books back. If you'd rather get your hands on that copy of the Teyvat Travel Guide sooner, you'd better come with me.
Lisa seems really scary right now. Paimon thinks it would be best if you answer her.
You really are such a considerate cutie. Let's see. First, we can go to the souvenir shop. It's called With Wind Comes Glory. So let's meet there shortly.
Bet you can't keep up with me! Bet you can't keep up with me! Bet you can't keep up with me!
You're here. Let's begin, shall we? Hello, Marjorie. Any exciting new items and why so surprised? Today is such a special day. It's only natural that I'd want a souvenir to remember it by. Since we came all this way, why don't we put our official business to one side for a moment? All work and no play makes life terribly mundane.
Well, if it's a souvenir you're after, you're in the right place. I'm sure you'll find something that strikes your fancy, Lisa. Or you could let your new friend pick something out for you. Make it more of an occasion.
Yes, yes! Let us pick!
This pair? Soft, puffy, and very comfortable. Certain to make a little girl, well, in this case a woman, look quite adorable. After all, they're the same kind worn by toy dolls. They're practically a badge of cuteness.
Bloomers? I'm sure to attract some strange looks if I dress up like a small child and
You sure? Can't change again once you've made your mind up.
Well, if you insist, I'll just use them as an extra pair of pajamas. Goodness, is that the time? Marjorie, one last thing. About the legend of Vanessa.
Oh, so you're a fan of the gallant Lady Vanessa too? Why didn't you say so? I have all sorts of items I could recommend. For example, this lion's tooth pendant with Vanessa's name carved into it. It was once a medal awarded to a knight by the great lady herself. Oh my goodness. I do apologize. I got so excited when you mentioned Vanessa. I didn't know that book was overdue, even though I take it with me everywhere. I can't believe I didn't put two and two together as soon as I saw you here.
Well, since you look up to Lady Vanessa so very much, please be more punctual next time.
Yes, Lisa. I will be, Lisa.
Let's go and find the next overdue book.
I'll race you there!
Welcome to Good Hunter. Table for two?
Three!
Oh! My apologies.
So we're gonna eat first and bring up the book situation.
Why, of course. The stress of work really takes the pleasure out of eating, don't you think?
Work is that bad, huh?
What does Lisa like to eat? She's been here a few times with Master Jean for afternoon tea before. I think she normally orders something vegetarian. A lady tends to eat cautiously on account of her physique, after all. On that note, I should probably be watching my own diet a little more.
Which should I choose?
Today's recommendation is the steak.
Why don't you order us something, cutie? I'm ever so curious to know what your tastes are. Imagine that making a good vegetable soup takes good quality ingredients, cooked in the right order, at the right heat, for the right length of time. At least, those are the principles that apply when one is making potions. But from what I've heard, soup making was a popular pastime among the witches of the past.
You sure? Can't change again once you've made your mind up.
Finished ordering? Sit here, let's dine together. A fine choice. I'm pleasantly surprised. A truly enchanting dish. Certainly a good fit for a witch. I am simply brimming with elemental energy after that.
Paimon's so full.
Time is getting on. I suppose I should carry on with this ghastly thing called work. Let's have a little chat with Sarah about her library.
Would you like to order something else?
No, thank you. We're quite satisfied. But I'm afraid I must ask you about the boar princess.
The boar brisket? I'm sorry. I think we took that off the menu.
She means the book you borrowed.
Oh, of course. I came straight to the restaurant after I borrowed it and completely forgotten that I even had it. I'm so sorry, Lisa. I will bring it to the library myself as soon as I finish work.
Okay, then. But make sure you don't forget this time. Right. On to our next stop, then, cutie.
Which should I choose?
It's been getting quite busy recently.
This is our final call for the day.
Welcome. Couples are our specialty.
Yes. Now, which book was it that has the line, "A date without flowers is a date without romance"? Why, it just so happens that I would, my kindest cutie.
Some flowers for Miss Lisa? What would you like? Mist flowers, over there in the corner. But don't touch them with your bare hands. You'll get frostbite. You want them? You're sure? Well, it's just that Lisa seems to use electro quite a lot. Things could get a little bit dangerous.
You sure? Can't change again once you've made your mind up.
Huh? These flowers are saturated with cryo energy. They could be very dangerous for me. Don't you know what happens when cryo meets electro? You certainly haven't been doing your homework. Meet me at the library after work, and I will give you some training on elemental reactions. If you still find it hard to memorize, maybe I'll have to give you a little taste of what it feels like to superconduct. Okay, time to get back to business. Donna, do you know why we're here?
Back to business? My business is selling flowers.
Once again, we see a total lack of respect for literature. The Pale Princess and the Six Pygmies. Ring a bell?
Yes. Well, what happened was... Oh no, what am I gonna do? I lost the book. A while back, I realized it was almost due, and I was getting ready to bring it back to the library, but I couldn't find it anywhere. I looked for days, but nothing. It's like somebody stole it. It should have been there, on my bedside table, right where I left it.
Uh-oh. That Lisa does some crazy things when she gets mad.
I heard that. Well, if it really was stolen, Donna's done nothing wrong. The blame lies with the book thief. And their punishment will be 10 times worse than stealing my book.
Like Paimon said, totally crazy!
Oh, don't worry about that. As long as I remain librarian, not a single book will go missing for good. I put a unique elemental marker on each book. Our thief will have left a nice set of clues for us to follow.
When did Lisa start taking her job so seriously? Paimon always thought she was a total slacker.
Hey, sweetie. I've heard your elemental sensitivity is very strong. Why not see what you can do?
Elemental sensitivity? Huh? Oh, Paimon's got it! Use your elemental sight to look for clues!
Can't you give me a better price?
I'll make tonight? Dandelions? Of course they're flowers.
Looking at the elemental traces, it does seem likely that the book was stolen.
So Donna didn't do anything wrong, Ab?
It's not from the restricted section, so it's hardly a book worth stealing. Whoever wanted this book so badly had a strange fixation indeed.
So what do we do now?
The elemental traces are very faint, but I can tell that the thief took it beyond the city walls. You must see it too, right, cutie? Let's follow the trail and have a look where our thief was headed, shall we?
Wind go with you.
I'll race you there!
The elemental traces are strong here, but it seems our thief did not stay for long. The trail keeps going. Let's keep looking. Closer. Come a little close. You're in for a little shock. Come a little closer. Come a little closer. You're in for a little shock.
Ah!
What's the hurry? What's the hurry?
It's further than I thought. Quite the intrepid explorer, our little thief.
Maybe we frighten the turtle back inside his shell.
What's the hurry?
It must be nearby. Using elemental sight, you can even detect magic. Follow the flow of magic to find the book.
The thief lives inside ruins? Mondstadt people do have some strange quirks.
Please do not jump to such a preposterous conclusion about the living habits of Mondstadt's residents. This seems far more likely to be the work of some none-too-friendly troublemakers. Stealing books is hardly the hilly churl's style. All they would use books for is to keep their campfire going anyway. This is more likely to be the Abyss Order's doing. They do seem to have a way of slipping in and out of places like ghosts, after all. Also, there's an elemental seal at the entrance. It looks like the result of an Abyss Mage's magic.
A seal? How are we gonna break it? Is this gonna turn into another huge ordeal?
Not to worry. If you think a little magic can keep me out, think—
Why is that?
Come on.
Whoa! So this is what Lisa's like when she's hard at work. Bigger in here than Paimon thought. Do we really have to go all the way inside?
If you borrow a book, you have to return it. There will be no exceptions. Come a little closer.
I didn't know you were such a slacker.
You're in for a little shock. Try not to enjoy this too much. You're in for a little shock.
Get him!
Cool it!
You're in for a little shock.
Dodge this! Freeze! Don't get frostbite!
For a little shock. Come a little closer. Closer. You're in for a little shock. Try not to enjoy this. You're in for a little shock. You're in for a little shock. urine for a little shock. Come a little clip.
Cool it.
Closer. Urine for a little shock. Come a little closer.
Yep.
Come a little closer. Come a little. Urine for a little urine for a little shock. Urine for a little shock. Urine for a little shock. Come a little closer. Urine for a little shock.
No one escapes my sight! Hey, go, go, fairy buddy!
Urine. Urine. Urine for a little shock. Come a little closer. Urine for a little shock. Urine for a little shock. Come a little closer. Come a little closer.
Dodge this! Cool it! Oh, so sorry. Freeze!
No one escapes my sight!
Wind blade!
Surrender and be gentle.
Freeze! What's the hurry? This moment will be frozen in time. Cool it!
Abyss Mage! Lisa was spot on!
Don't get frostbite! Freeze! Closer. Closer. Come a little closer. Come a little closer. You're in for a little shot. Come a little closer. You're in for a little
Windblade!
How did you find this place? It's so well hidden!
I have no interest in finding out where you little rascals hide yourselves away, but I do want my book back. Tell me, how is it that you have the time to conceal your stronghold and apply a magic seal, but not to sign out a library book in the proper manner? You have no respect whatsoever for other people's work.
You just want the book? I was unaware that anyone in Mondstadt was concerned with unearthing the secret hidden inside this book. Who are you?
The librarian, although I believe that should be quite clear already. Return the book. This is an ultimatum.
Since you insist on concealing your identity, I have all the less reason to give you that book. After all, it contains the secret. What are you doing? Such concentrated elemental power! Please don't!
Naughty boys who don't do what they're told need a little punishment to keep them in line. This is why I call it troublesome work. We'll just need to find the book ourselves. It should be around here somewhere.
Six pygmies! Paimon remembers that.
that's the one. It's a good thing it isn't damaged.
Otherwise what? Are you...
I would have probably have needed to dish out a little taste of one of my potions in that case. Then again, as I said, it doesn't appear to have any abnormal elemental properties, save for the markings I put on it.
Yeah, it seems like just an average storybook.
As far as my duties as a librarian go, my troublesome work is finished. Since this book has piqued your interest, why don't I let you borrow it? There's no time limit for you. I will register you as custodian rather than borrower. This is an exclusive privilege reserved for trusted citizens only.
Exclusive privilege? Why does Paimon feel this is just your sneaky way of offloading your troublesome work onto someone else?
Excuse me? Are you in some way dissatisfied with my work? Good. You're amenable to reason, then. My work here is done. I'm going back. Don't forget to register at the library when you have a spare moment. You've returned. The paperwork is done. You are now the custodian of this book.
Thank you, Miss Lisa. But Paimon thinks we're forgetting something. Look, over there on the shelf. Isn't that the Teyvat travel guide? And look how many copies there are.
The Teyvat travel guide is a serial publication. It is not part of the library's formal collection.
Oh.
Take one. Consider it your compensation for being Lisa's little helper today. With you by my side, my troublesome work was a little less dull than usual.
The Teyvat travel guy was just bait to get us to do a day's work.
I hadn't anticipated that a few routine returns inquiries would take us out of the city, let alone down into some underground ruins. As compensation for dragging you into all this bother, take these souvenirs.
Wow! Lisa went and bought us some special souvenirs!
In fact, they were intended for our next outing. But, never mind. We can discuss next time's activity when the time comes. I hope you are looking forward to it.
more like it.